it's Tuesday. I have successfully recovered from Monday night's festivities, not as quickly or as well as I did in my 20s, but I am here. I'm in downtown Tampa, Channelside District, actually, for a series of events that they have going on, one of which is the Rail Industry Policy Leaders Reception, which is starting right now. So let's go check it out.
Someone who's well known to all of us, Congressman Micah of Florida. Congressman?
Well, first of all, I want to thank Mike Ward and Matt Rose so much for hosting this and the other hosts today and having us here. Welcome to Florida, the folks I met. Where are these folks from? Did they say Sweden?
Stockholm.
Yeah. That's great. Stay and spend a lot of money. We need the euro. Thank you for employing thousands of people. I know some of you, CSX and others, have programs to employ our returning veterans. Thank you for that, too. And you really make America go and grow and do what it does best, and that's the business of the country. So thank you so much. Enjoyed working with... I see a few faces over the years who have been just wonderful allies. So proud to have you here. My wife, where's Pat? Ever suffering Pat. Thank you, Pat. Now we need to just do what, again, you all do best and America does best, is get us moving, the economy growing, and everyone having economic opportunity that many in this room have been so privileged and honored and blessed to have. So thanks again for hosting us, and welcome, and just enjoy the rest of the week. As they used to say, what, party on, dude?
So I'm just now leaving the Rail event. Had a great time getting to know Congressman Micah's staff from the Orlando Winter Park area. Very smart guy, very great staff, and I'm going to go to the next event, so check out. So it's been a long day, and I'm here in Tampa for what is no doubt the most important event of the day, and that's actually to get on with my parents. Yay!
Find us on their own,
We have a Facebook page, a website, a Twitter page. We actually did Rick Scott's first public appearance. There were about 400 people in attendance for that. That drew a lot of members. And so a lot of times the speakers themselves draw people into our clubs, and then they meet folks. They're like-minded individuals, and so then they make the decision themselves. At the RNC, we've actually met a number of people who have lived here and knew nothing about us, and then, of course, have been exposed to us at the YR events or at the different convention functions. And so we're constantly recruiting. A lot of it's through personal relationships, some of it's through professional relationships, and some of it's by pure accident.
Ooh, yeah. Things are gonna get easier. Ooh, yeah. Things will be bright.
So we are just now leaving the Green Iguana in South Tampa. It's a little after 11 o'clock. It's getting kind of late, so it's time to head back to Sarasota. I got to speak with a few more young Republicans this evening, which is really nice. I did not get a chance to talk with Jeff Atwater, which I had been looking forward to, but I know the convention's crazy. We were watching it from inside the bar on the TVs, and I am actually really anxious to get home to find out what Candace did today in the convention. I saw some pictures she put up on Facebook. Looks like she had a great time, and I'm sure she has a great story to tell. So stay tuned to politicallypersonal.com.